It is to the analysts who are watching Dante's Boxing Nation. Keep watching. Otherwise,
you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? You know, Eagles World just did a video talking about this situation. Triple G openly avoiding Andre Ward in an interview, making it very clear he wants no part, and I mean no part, of the champion Andre Ward. Now, Eagle, he spoke a lot of truth in that video, and we all know the truth hurts. But I want to go ahead and I want to give you guys my take on the whole situation. Because there are so many emotionally attached fans in the sport of boxing. You have a lot of people out there who do videos that I used to notice really when I first started watching YouTube, where they would try their best to take both sides because they're afraid they're going to hurt somebody's feelings. You know, they'll basically say something that's truthful. But then they say, well, let me try to say something about the other fighter so these guys don't get mad at me. Basically having to apologize while you're doing the video, right? Let me tell you something, man. This ain't kindergarten. Just because I give one kid five blocks to play with don't mean I gotta give your ass five blocks to play with as well. Maybe your ass don't deserve to play with five blocks, you know? In kindergarten, if you say, Travis, you did a good job, what are the other kids gonna say? Hey, what about me? Didn't I do a good job? What about me, right? So in kindergarten, when you're dealing with five-year-old kids, you may be forced to say that everyone did a good job, even though you know they didn't do as well of a good job as Travis did, okay? Now that's kindergarten. So why do we have grown-ass men on YouTube and blogs? You sit over here and you say, Andre Ward is a great fighter. Guillermo Rigo, pound for pound, one of the best fighters in the world. Then these emotional fans come out saying, hey, what about Canelo? Isn't he one of the greatest fighters in the world as well? Isn't he pound for pound too? How come you're talking so good about Andre Ward, Floyd Mayweather, and Guillermo Rigo, but you ain't talking that good about Canelo? What about Nonito Donaire? How come you won't give them the same credit? On that kindergarten shit, right? Listen, man, I don't give a damn how much you cry. I don't give a damn how much your feelings are hurt. This ain't love and hip hop. You ain't gonna get no apology parties on my channel, okay? We here to speak the whole truth, and that's what it is. Listen, fans, you cannot have it both ways. You cannot have it both ways. Once again, emotionally attached fans are forced to contradict themselves. The fans right now that are defending Gennady Golovkin for ducking Andre Ward, these are the same fans that are calling Floyd Mayweather a million pussies, gay runner, scared, ducking everyone. If you even look at Floyd too hard, he'll duck you, according to them, right? All this ridiculous talk, the same people that are defending Triple G are saying these things about Floyd Mayweather. Even though we know that Floyd Mayweather negotiated with Manny Pacquiao on numerous occasions, that means both fighters had an interest in making the fight. Gennady Golovkin, on the other hand, he doesn't even have an interest in making the fight. He made it very clear. Oh, no, no, no. I'm not interested in that fight right now. Let me do me and let him do him. He's letting you know, I don't want to negotiate. I don't care about no drug testing. I don't care about no money. I don't want to fight him at all. You got it, guys? So this throws a huge monkey wrench into the mix when it comes to these biased-ass fans trying to defend Triple G. I mean, usually we always have the debates. One side is saying, this guy is ducking. The other side is saying, no, he's not ducking. They're defending the guy, right? But what happens when the fighter comes out and openly says, I am ducking him. I don't want to fight him. Then what happens? You know what these fans do? They were defending him. You know what they do? Instead of saying, okay, you were right. He doesn't want to fight him. No, they don't say that. Instead, they go after the guy that's calling out Golovkin, Andre Ward. They start attacking him. Why don't you pick on someone else, Ward? Why don't you fight Kovalev? Why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? You think you're so badass. You think you're a star. You think you're Mayweather. I heard people sending ridiculous messages like that. Ridiculous shit, right? Just because Andre Ward is calling out their guy, right? Because see, this is the whole thing. Golovkin is their hope right now. That is the guy that they love right now. So they will do anything to protect him. But what's so crazy is when Andre Ward was calling out Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., when he was a little bit hotter, they did the same thing with Chavez. They tried to protect Chavez. And they said, why are you picking on Chavez, Ward? Why don't you go fight Golovkin, right? Now that Ward is calling out Golovkin, why don't you go fight Kovalev? You see how this shit works? You're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. Since when do we punish fighters for calling out other fighters, right? You cannot have it both ways. One minute you guys are complaining about a fighter ducking someone. Now you're complaining about a fighter calling out somebody? Are you serious? And then to suggest that Ward should leave Golovkin alone and go after Kovalev, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense financially or logically. Why? Because we all know that Golovkin is the much bigger name. We already know that HBO would rather see Ward versus Golovkin than Ward versus Kovalev. Not only that, but you gotta think about it. Golovkin has been working hard to become the face of HBO, okay? He's been doing everything HBO wants him to do. He's been knocking out everyone, name fighters, and his name has become big in the sport of boxing, at least from the diehard fans, right? Why would Ward go after a guy who is in the beginning stages of where Golovkin was like 2 years ago? Because that's where Kovalev is now. Kovalev is at the beginning stages trying to become a big name. Golovkin has already reached that status. Not only that, but he was one of the most avoided fighters in the sport. And now Andre Ward is one of the most avoided fighters as well. You guys know deep down, it makes way more sense that Ward and Golovkin, they get matched up. Golovkin already said that he will fight at 168. He has no problem fighting at 168. He said, I will just fight certain fighters. What that really means is, I'll pretty much fight anyone at 168 except for Andre Ward. That's really what it means. And for the record, I believe that Kovalev would be a much easier fight for Andre Ward than a Golovkin fight would be. Golovkin is far more skilled than Kovalev is and has a way better defense than Kovalev does. You know, I always tell you guys on this channel that the truth will always come out. The truth will always break free, regardless how much you try to hide the truth. And I believe that these fans contradicting themselves in this Triple G situation, trying to attack the guy that calls him out while Triple G openly ducks him, it proves that these fans, they never thought that Floyd Mayweather was a ducker, he was gay runner, and he was all of this, he was afraid. It proves deep down, they just didn't like the guy. And it really never had anything to do with negotiations or skills and had anything to do with boxing, really. It had everything to do with emotions. That's all I got, guys. I'm on to the next one.